Carl and this is Erica, and we're here to talk about the fifth principle of green chemistry, which states that the use of auxiliary substances such as solvents and separation agents should be made unnecessary wherever possible and innocuous when used.
When performing a chemical reaction, there are a number of different materials and processes involved. The most basic breakdown of a reaction begins with the starting materials, shown here as a square and a triangle, which undergo a transformation to give a final product.
But in practice, most reactions require the use of solvents and auxiliaries, which are substances that don't actually contribute to the structure of the final compound, but are necessary to help drive the reaction to completion and isolate the final product.
For example, solvents are often required to dissolve the starting materials to keep them mixed so they can better interact with each other. Solvents are also used to control the temperature of reactions.
Another way solvents are used is for the purification and separation of the final product. In an ideal reaction, each square only reacts with the triangle to form the final product. But in reality, a variety of other byproducts are also formed, and this has to be separated from the final product.
Many methods of separation require the use of a large amount of solvent. A common technique used to separate and isolate compounds in a mixture is column chromatography, where the mixture is passed through the solid phase of a column using a solvent. As the mixture travels down the column, the compounds separate because they travel at different rates.
Though column chromatography works well for separations, a large amount of solvent is used in the process. The majority of chemical processes often require massive amounts of solvents to make and isolate the final product compared to the amount of product itself. This generates a large amount of solvent waste. Therefore, some green chemistry research is focused on reducing solvent use and even on designing solvent-free syntheses.
By putting Principle 5 into action, we can help reduce the total amount of waste created and lower the impact on us and the environment at times when solvents cannot be avoided. Some solvents are more harmful than others, so it is also important to consider the specific solvent being used in a reaction.
In recent years, several chemical companies have developed solvent selection guides just for this purpose. You can see links for them in the description box down below. These guides compare similar solvents based on their impact on human health and the environment, making it easy for chemists to choose the greenest option available for their reaction.
A good practical example of this is the replacement of the solvent dichloromethane, or DCM, in these types of separations. DCM is persistent in the environment and associated with acute and chronic toxicity in humans and should therefore be replaced whenever possible.
In 2012, a study was published highlighting several greener options for replacing DCM in chromatography. They also created an easy-to-use guide for selecting alternative solvent mixtures. Let's head into the lab to show you just how well one of these greener alternatives works.
For this experiment, we will be isolating one of the many colorful compounds in the spinach extract. We have two columns already prepared here. In column number one, we are going to separate the mixture using DCM with 5% ethyl acetate as our solvent. And in column number two, we will use the greener solvent of choice of 15% isopropanol and heptanes.
After putting our solvents and spinach extract into the top of each column, we let the liquids flow through the column, which causes the chlorophyll compounds and the spinach to separate. We'll speed up the footage so you can quickly see what happens.
So, as you can see, differently colored compounds separate from each other in both of the columns. We collected the first yellow compound successfully using both solvent systems, showing that it can be separated from the rest. The colors left in the column look slightly different because we have different solvent systems. Column chromatography is a complicated process, but if you want to learn more about it, you can check out our blog post in the description. Overall, you can see that the alternative solvent mixture is a good replacement for the traditional choice of DCM in separations.
When given a choice of solvents that can accomplish the same task, it makes sense to always choose the safest and greenest option available, not just in chromatography. Thanks for tuning in, and remember to use principle number 5 by reducing solvents and auxiliaries wherever possible, and always choose the greenest solvent option available.
Be sure to like this video and subscribe to see the rest of our series on the principles of green chemistry. If you want to learn more about the Green Chemistry Initiative, check us out at our website or on Facebook and Twitter.